Dear students, we are beginning with session 6 of Computational Thinking and Programming, Part 2, Unit 1. Recently, we have been studying revision of the basics of Python for the last 5 sessions. Today, we are in a position to perform a practical by learning how we can take input from the user. So in the last session we have covered type conversion and type casting. In this session we are going to see how type conversion and type casting are being used in a program. In the last session we also studied how to format the output in the print statement and also make the output more presentable. We use the concept of placeholders for generating the output. In this session, we have two specific tasks to do. First of all, we are going to see how can we take input from the user. And secondly, after the end of this session, we will be in a position to perform our first practical, and which you are going to record in your practical notebook. Python input. So what is the need of Python input? Why do we need to provide user input in a program? Normally, if we don't take user input from the console, then what happens? We can design static programs only. That is, if we are going to run the programs, they are not going to be much useful, because most of the time the user requirement changes. That is, the input set given by the user changes. And so we need to make dynamic programs where we can take different inputs from the users and generate different outputs. So that program will be more productive rather than the static programs without taking user input. Let's see an example in which we write a program to calculate simple interest. We have already set the principal amount to 20,000, rate as 0.2 and time as 2. Calculating the interest, you know the formula, it is principal into rate into time upon 100. And we simply print the simple interest. Now let's see after execution what happens to this program. So here is the first program, example 1, static program without user input. Principal, rate and time have been set. We have changed the value of rate in this. Interest is calculated as P into R into T upon 100, where you know what PRT means, and we have simply printed that simple interest is interest. So after execution, the output is simple interest is 2000. Again, if we re-execute this program, it will generate the same output. So this program is not much useful, because we need to design a program that is going to give different output for different sets of inputs. This program generates the same output every time you execute it. To allow flexibility, we might want to take the input from the user. So let's see how we can take the input from the user and make this program more productive. So for taking input from the user, we need the input function. The syntax of input is input, and in the parenthesis, you have to write the prompt. Now what is a prompt? A prompt means you have to write a statement suggesting the user what type of input is required. For example, if you require the user to enter a number, then you can write within prompt, the prompt is written within single or double quotes, you can write, please enter a number. So the prompt string is optional, and let's see why the prompt is included in the input statement, but you need to include the prompt, although it is optional. Let's see an example in which we use a prompt. Number is equal to num is equal to input, enter a number. We have used the input function, and within parentheses and within single quotes we have entered a string, enter a number, and we have then printed whatever has been entered by the user. We have printed that. So let's again execute this. So here is the second program example. Num is equal to input, enter a number, and we have simply displayed the num. So there is a text box on which the prompt is written, enter a number. This is the reason why we use prompt, because it will ask you to enter a number. Otherwise you may not be knowing what value to enter in this field. So when it says enter a number, or more specifically if you want the user to input an integer or a float, you can write enter a float, enter an integer. You can customize this accordingly. Suppose we have entered 5 and we press enter, that 5 is displayed. We have written num, that statement outcomes 5. So we have seen what happens when we write a prompt. Now we can execute this program without prompt, and let's see what happens if we execute it without prompt. So here is the third example in which we are not using a prompt. So we have simply written num is equal to input, and inside the parentheses we have not included any prompt, and we have displayed the num. So here it is asking for something. We don't know what it is asking for because we have omitted the prompt string. So let's enter 5 here, and it displays 5. Now in both the examples you can see that when we are displaying 5, it is written within single quotes. This means that the value of num it is taking, although it is taking the user input as a number, but it is printing it as a string. So let's see why does this happen. We will see later on. Now let's see another example in which we want to find the sum of two numbers taken as user input. So the user inputs two numbers, number 1, number 2, and we find the sum of number 1 and number 2 in number 3. And then we print that the sum of first number plus second number is third number. So first of all, let's see, after executing this in the code editor, here is the program. We have taken number 1 is equal to input, enter number 1, given the prompt enter number 1. In number 2 we have again used the input function, and we have written enter number 2 as a prompt. So the user will come to know that he has to enter number 1 and number 2, two numbers, and then this program will find the sum of both the numbers and store it in, or that will be referred by number 3, and then it will print sum of, that is the string, number 1, whatever number 1 user has entered, and number 2 is number 3. So let's enter the number 1 is 5. It asks for another number 2. Let's enter 5 for this also. Now it is printing that the sum of 5 and 5 is 55, whereas the sum of 5 and 5 must be 10. So there is some problem with this code. We will find out what the problem is. Here we see that the enter value is treated as a string, because whatever number we are entering, as we have seen in the last example also, the value of the number which we have entered is an integer, whereas that number is being printed or internally taken as string. So number 1 and number 2, if they are string, then number 3 will be string plus string, that is concatenation operation. 5 plus 5 is 55 in terms of string. So 55 is a string, number 3 is printed as a string. So what can we do to convert these inputs from string to integer? We have studied in the last session about typecasting. So the input function takes the value entered as string. So it considers the value as string. If we try to enter a float or an int, but input function will take it as string. So what we need to do in order to convert it into an integer or float, we need to use typecasting. In the last session we have seen what is typecasting. We can cast or convert from one type to another. So this is an example in which we have not used typecasting. So the value entered is taken as a string and the operation performed is not addition but it is concatenation. Now to overcome the problem which we encountered in example 4, we have created another program in which we have used typecasting, that is whatever input function is taking as string that is being casted into integer and that is referred by number 1. Similarly, the number entered, second number entered, that is taken as a string by the input function, that is converted into integer. And you may refer to the last class where we have used typecasting in order to clarify this. Number 2 is referring the second value, and number 3 is equal to number 1 plus number 2. Let's see whether this program works or not. Example 5. Okay, so it is asking for number 1 and number 2. It is similar to the earlier example, but here we have taken typecasting, that is we are trying to convert that string value into integer. So let's take the same set of inputs which we have taken in the last example. The first value we have taken it as 5 and the second value also we are taking it as 5 and the sum which is printed is 10. So this is the correct program in which we have used type conversion. You can also use float in place of integer if you need the first number to be float and the second number to be float as well. So now returning to the example number 1 in which we were trying to find the simple interest by taking user input, whereas this program was a static program in which we have predefined values of principal rate and time and it generates the same output every time it is executed. So our objective of performing the practical examples, conducting these practical examples, was to understand how we can take user input, how can we use typecasting in a program, and finally we have converted example 1 into example 6, where in 1 we were using static values of various variables, whereas in 6 we are taking dynamic values from the user. How principal is equal to float input enter the principal amount. So whatever principal amount will be entered, that input function will take it as string and then that will be converted into float. You can take integer as well if you want to consider principal as integer. Similarly, rate is equal to float input, enter the rate of interest, time is equal to float input, enter the time in years. So we have taken the values of principal, rate and time from the user and we are calculating interest as principal into rate into time upon 100 and then we are printing the value of interest. So again we are going to see this in code editor how this program functions. It is asking for principal amount. Let's take the same values which we have taken in the first example. $20,000. Rate of interest 5. Then time in years is 2. It produces 2,000. Now let's re-execute this. The principal amount is taken as, suppose 10,000, the rate of interest is say 4 and the time in years be 3 years. So you can see that this is a dynamic program in which we can give different set of inputs and the program generates different set of output. That is, this program is more productive and useful than the program 1. So now you are in a condition to perform the first practical of our session. You need to write a program to find the simple interest based upon the number of years. If the number of years is more than 12, rate of interest is 10, otherwise 15. So what you need to do in this program, you need to take the values of principal and time from the user, and the rate is given as, if the number of years the user has entered is more than 12, the rate of interest is 10, otherwise it is 15. That is, if the number of years entered by the user is less than 12, it is 15. So this program will be based on user input typecasting. Moreover, you need to apply the condition, if else condition, in which you have to check that if number of years is greater than 12, then interest is 10, else interest is 15. So you have to note down the given program in your practical notebook after executing it, whatever device you are having, like smartphone, desktop, laptop, or whatever devices you are having, you can execute on those devices. Either you can use the apps like QPython on smartphone, or you can use Python IDEs, various IDEs available for the desktop version as well. You can execute the program, you must execute it, and then note it down in your practical notebook on the right hand side, that is the lining side, and on the blank side, you have to write on the blank side whatever set of inputs you have provided to the program and whatever outputs have been generated. So thank you for watching. In the next session, we are going to see how the Python import statement works and what is the usefulness of import statement, what are various modules.